Hi everyone, welcome to javatechie. In this tutorial, we'll discuss how to implement basic authentication using Spring Boot and Angular. So already I covered session about Spring security using basic authentication and authorization. So if anyone not aware on this, please go through my Spring security playlist so that it will easy for you to understand. So this is what the Spring security playlist I have. So in this current project, we are going to reuse the same code, Spring Security Basic Authentication and Authorization. So I will add this link in video description so that you guys can check it out. Okay. So we'll reuse the same code for Spring Boot security, and the Angular project we'll create from scratch. Okay. So let's get started. Let's go to Eclipse. So already I created one Spring Boot project by enable Spring security. So if you'll go inside this, I have main class where I expose two REST endpoint. One will be default, who will return me one string message, and the second one will return me the list of user object. So I hard code the user object here. Okay. So if you'll go to the security config, I am enabling security for any endpoint. I want it to be fully authenticated. And I hardcode the username and password. Username javatechie and password is JT143 and the role is user. Okay. So let's run this backend code to verify whether it is working or not. So it's already up and running on port 8080. So let me verify once. Yeah. So let's go to browser and try to hit our REST endpoint. Localhost 8080. Yeah. So it's asking the credential. Give the username javatechie. And password JT143. We can see the result here, right? Authenticated successfully. Let's try to hit the second REST endpoint, which will be get users. Yeah, we can see the record, right? So the backend code is working as expected. Let's move on and let's create a Angular project from scratch. So let's go to Angular project. So type your command. And we know to generate a new project. So the command is ng new, then you can give your project name. So I'm giving user service client, enter it. So it is asking us to enable routing. So we want yes, and we want CSS. Now it will take a couple of minutes to generate our Angular project. So our project successfully created. Now go to Visual Studio Code, open your folder. So the name we created, user service client. So let me close this. Now go to the terminal. So here we just need to create two component, because I want to perform separate, like for login, I want to perform login component. And to get the list of users, I want to display it in home component. Okay. So that's the reason I'm going to create two component here. The command to generate component, ng generate component, and you can give the name of your component, login. So it created component file and it updated in app.module.ts. So similarly, we want one more component, that will be home. So create that. So it created home component. Now we need to generate one service to do our REST API call. So to generate a service, there is a command ng generate service, then you can give your service name. So I'm giving something like REST API. Okay. Yeah. So it created a service with the name REST API. Now go to your app.module.ts. Go inside app. And we need to register this service, right? The service name is REST API. So go to these providers. We can type your REST API. Yeah. And in app.module.ts, there is something wrong. Yeah. So in app.module.ts, we need to add the ng model, as we are going to get the username and password from input form. Along with that, as we are going to do the REST call using HTTP client, that also we need to import here. Okay, so let me add those two fields. So add those two modules in this import section. Okay, now we need to add the import statement for it. So add it here. So now let's go to our REST API service.ts and let's write the logic to do the REST API call. Okay. So to perform REST API call, we need HTTP client. So let's inject it first, mention the scope, then variable name. Then we can specify HTTP client. So the second one, it should be import from Angular command.http. Okay, so now let's write REST API call. So if you observe in our backend code, we have two REST API. First one will login and another one will be get users. So first let's write for this one, where we need to pass the username and password as part of request header to validate the user authentication. Okay, so go to here. Let's write a method something like public login, then give the username of type string. Similarly, pass the password of type string, right? So here what we can do, let's use the HTTP dot get method and we can pass the URL here, HTTP then localhost 8080, right? So this is how we usually call our REST API, isn't it? But if you observe, we enable Spring security and always each API will expect the username and password as part of request header, right? So if you'll pass direct URL, it will not work. So for that, we need to add the header here, right? So declare one variable, something like headers, then create new HTTP headers. So in this section, we need to pass our username and password. Okay. So for that, first we need to specify the authorization. Then we need to specify the authentication type is basic authentication. Then give your username and password. Okay. But for to provide your username and password, there should be someone who will encrypt it and we'll decrypt it, right? So for that, there is one more API, or we can say there is one more inbuilt function. Here you need to pass the username and then we need to give the password here. So what we did here, so let me close this first. Yeah, so if you observe here, we created one header, HTTP headers. So this should be small u. Yeah, so we specify the authorization type of basic and this BTOA means binary to ASCII. So he will help us to pass our username and password. So this is what the username and password will get from the method argument. So basically we are going to create one login form and from that form using ng model, we'll extract these two fields and we'll pass to this method. Okay. So now we created HTTP headers. That headers we need to pass as part of our request URL. Okay, so for that, specify the headers, then specify here the response type, because if you observe this particular REST API call will return us plain string, right? That's the reason we need to specify the response type that we are getting text instead of JSON. Okay, so now let's do REST API call for another one method, which will be get users. So let me copy this, we'll change the URL and method argument. Okay, so the method name we can give something like get users. Here you don't want to pass the username and password, because in first method, login method, I wrote username and password in method argument because we are going to create one login form. From that form itself, we will get the username and password. So in this get users, what we can do, we'll add one button. On click on that button, I want to populate list of user from my backend code. Okay, so that's the reason I don't want to pass the method argument here. So what else we can change? We can change here the URL get users, and we don't want the response type as text here because it will return list of JSON object, list of user object. Okay, so here what I can do, instead of pass here, I can hard code the username and password here. So let's add Java techie, and password we have JT143. Or better, instead of hard code here, what we can do, we can declare it in as a global variable. Okay, so let username Java techie, and similarly specify the password, let password equal to JT143. Now we can pass this username and password here. So if you go here, no need to pass the hardcode username password in binary to ASCII conversation. Okay, so what we can do here, give the username, and here we can add the password. Fine. So we wrote REST API call for all the two REST endpoints which we are exposing from backend. So now let's write the component.ts specific to the login. Okay, so go to login component and then go to login component.ts. So first let me declare two variable here which we will get from the login form using ng model. So the field will be username of type string, similarly password of type string, and as it will return one message which of type string, so better to specify any also. Yeah, so from this login component we are going to call this REST API service, right? So first we need to inject that here, private service, then REST API service. Yeah, so here we can write one method, something like do login. Okay, so let's go to this service once again. Yeah, so here we need to return the value or else we can't capture in this component.ts, right? So let me return that value. Now go here. So here what we can do, we have the service now with us dot login. Here we need to pass the username and password, and username and password we'll get from the form. Now assign it to one variable so that we can verify the response what we are getting. Okay, so what I can do here, response dot subscribe, then get the data, and I just want to print it in console. Okay, later we will map this data to message and we can display it in our front end. Okay, so we wrote our component.ts, even we wrote our service. Now what we can do, go to our HTML. So here let me add one form where we will have two input fields. So I already have the template, let me add it. Go to the Visual Studio, then add the form page, and then we need to add the corresponding CSS. So I already copied that. So let's go to login component.cs and add it here. So guys, basically this template you can get from this site. So I will add this link, if anyone want they can refer it. So you can find n number of template here and I used some of them. Yeah, so let's go to code. So we added CSS, let me save this file, and we added HTML, right? So if you observe in HTML, I have the name called username with ng model username, so that the value will be reflect from this HTML to component. This is what we learn in our two-way data binding, right? Yeah, so two value I am getting from the form page, and then I have one submit button. So in this submit button, I am doing the method call to this particular method. Okay, so the method name is do login. Let me change the method here. Now save it. So once you will click on this submit, the request will go to this corresponding do login method, and from doLogin method we are invoking the service class login method. So if you go inside this, from this login, based on your input username and password, it will authorized, it will prepare the header, and it will do your backend call using our REST API. Okay, fine. So we are done with our first REST API configuration and all. Now we missed one thing. We need to add the routing, right? So for that, let's go to our there will be one TS file with routing. Yeah, app routing module.ts. Here we need to specify routing based on URL and component. So I want, if the request will come with the URL login, then I want it to redirect to the login component. Okay. Similarly, let me copy this. If the request is come with slash home, then it should redirect to home component. So home, then it should redirect to home component. And this login component, I want it to be a default one. So for that, what I can do, let me copy this. If user will not give any URL, then redirect my request to this login page or this login component and specify the path match. It can be full. Okay. Yeah. So we enable routing. Now what we can do, if you will go to your app.component.html, we don't want these inbuilt HTML tag and all. So router outlet is there. He will take care to redirecting your URL to corresponding component. So let's open the terminal and let's run this application, ng serve --open. So it compiled successfully and it opened the browser. So what I can do, I will open it in Google Chrome so that we can verify the status of our request. So yeah, so open here. So let me inspect it. Now give the username, which is javatechie, and give the password JT143. Now click on login. We got the error here. If you go to header, we are getting option method and 401 access cross allow origin, and it will allow for get, head, post, all the method. Something we did mistake in our backend code. So here we disable the cross origin. So if you go to security config, yeah, so one thing we missed here, we need to add http.course, because if you observe in request, we are getting the request type is option, right? So for that, we need to enable this. Okay, now let me save this. Yeah, now go to the browser again, refresh the page once. So let's clear all the file here. Now if I will give the username javatechie and password same JT143, if I will hit the login, yeah, now we are getting the success, right? The first one for option and second one for our actual get API call. Okay, so if you will go to this response, you can see authenticated successfully here. This is what we are returning from our controller, isn't it? So now let's access the second API, which will be return the list of user object. So what we can do, go here. So if you will go to this login component.html, we are not returning anything, right? We are just printing it in console, in component.ts, right? So instead of print it, what I want here, if the user is authenticated successfully, then I want it to redirect to home page. Okay. So for that, we need router here. So inject the router. Okay. So use this router here. So instead of print it in console, what we can do, router dot navigate, then I want it to navigate to home component, right? So that's why I need to provide the URL of home component, which will be slash home. So using this router, from one component you can navigate to another component. So let's test it whether it is working or not. Now go to the browser. Now I am not going to inspect it. Let's give the name javatechie and password JT143. Now if I click on login, now it redirects me to the home component, right? So in home component we'll add one button. On click on that button, it will go to controller or service. It will return us the list of user object. So for that I will take the help of this bootstrap 4 documentation. So we are going to use the button here. Let me choose any of one here. Yeah, so let me copy this. Now go to your code, go to your home.component.html. It is displaying home works, right? We don't want this, we want one button to enable here. So we'll get bunch of button here. Let's remove all, we just need one. So we want the primary one, and I don't want all those top. Yeah, so here what we can do, name it something like get or else find users, find users, and then we need to provide here on click, then our method name, right? So this should be click, then give the method name. So method name we'll add later because we don't write any method in our component.ts to get list of user from service. So what we can do, let's write a method here, something like get users. Okay, this get users method will return us the list of users. So what I can do, I will mention the variable users of type any. Then here what we can do, let's do the service call. So to do the service call, I need to inject the service here first. So give the name service, then our service name is REST API service. Yeah, so here let's declare a variable, let response equal to service dot get employees. The method name is get users. So let me get, yeah, get users, and then capture this value with the help of this response, subscribe it, and in subscribe get the value, then map it to our users, right? This dot users equal to data, right? Now add a semicolon here. Yeah, so we are done with the method. Now let's specify the same method to our click event, right? So where we mention that home.component.html, here we can specify get users method. So once the user will click on this button, it will call the get users method which we mention in our home.component.ts, right? From this again it will go and call the service get users. From service it will do the rest call, right? So now what we can do, let's add a table structure in our HTML to render the user object. So go to this bootstrap, we can find here tables. So let me use the first one. So already I copied the link and script, all those stuff. Only I need this div, right? Yeah, so let me copy up to this. Now go and paste it in your HTML, home.component.html. So let me add one more div here. So in div, what we can do, we can remove all the hard code value here because we'll get those value from the service call. So let me remove, yeah, this one. Then here let's change the header name. We have the user object. Let me verify what user object contains. So let's go to this user class, ID name, email and mobile, right? So give the header first ID, then we have name, then we have email, and one more we want, that is mobile number, right? So add it here. Now we just want to generate, or we just want to render the value which we are getting from the service, right? So that's why we need to use ng4 let user of users, right? So here what we can do, we just use the double brushes here to get that particular value, user.id. Now same way we can get all the field, right? So let me paste here id, then the second one will be name, then third one will be email, and fourth one will be mobile, right? Yeah. Now let me format it. Yeah, so let me remove this top. We don't need to display this header. And okay, so let's save this. Now let's go to browser. So what we can do, let's go to our home page or login page. Give the URL here, javatechie username and password as JT143. Now click on login. It is redirecting to the home page, right? Never. So here we find the button here, right? And we get the table header. So once you click on this find users, it will go to the REST API call and it will fetch the list of user object, right? So let's hit this button. Yeah, let me zoom it. We're getting the two object which I hard code in my controller, right? So let me show you that. Yeah, this is what the two object we are getting in our ng site, right? So yeah, this is how we can integrate with Spring security to our Angular. But if you will go to code in service, let me open the service. In each API call, we are hard coding here the username and password, right? For first one, I get it from the form page, and rest whatever the method I need to write here for them to pass this username and password as part of headers, I need to hard code them. But whenever we want to integrate with any database, that time we don't know the username or password or whoever the user is going to access our application, we don't know that, right? So in such case, instead of hard code, how we can make it unique, right? So once user logged in each API call, he don't need the username and password. How we can design such kind of application? So in my next tutorial, I will explain that how to avoid hard code username and password in ng site. Okay. That's all about this particular video, guys. Thanks for watching this video. Meet you soon with a new concept.